How cool is this jersey? So it's a FaZe CSGO jersey. Where is the flag? British flag there. Name on the back. Incredibly cool. Anyway, let's talk about ThinkPads. They are some of the best laptops you can buy, in my humble opinion. My best performing video was about a ThinkPad. Mine was a T450, rock solid little machine. But since then, my needs have changed. I own a 16-inch MacBook Pro now. I have done for almost 3 years. Long-term review will be coming out about that, by the way. And as I wanted something thin and light to complement it with good connectivity, good battery life, and that wonderful ThinkPad name, today we're going to be taking a look at the brilliant ThinkPad T480S. Is it still worth buying in 2022, or should you go with something different, maybe from Dell, maybe from HP? Hey guys, I'm Ryan Thomas, and this is my review of the ThinkPad T480S in 2022. Let me first address a comment that maybe some ThinkPad owners are commenting right now. The T480 non-S is considered by many as one of the latest or last great ThinkPads. Compared to the T480S, it is slightly bulkier at 1.6 kilos over 1.3, but it has an external removable battery as well as the internal battery for better battery life. It is more upgradable in many ways, more than one. And overall, because of its modularity and upgradability, it is considered to be one of the best last ThinkPads, with the S being sort of more modernized, less upgradable. You get the picture. The T480S is a 14-inch thin and light laptop. My model has 8GB of RAM, the Core i5 8250U, and a 256GB NVMe SSD. It also has a 1080p IPS display and Windows 11 Pro loaded, though I'll likely be switching to Manjaro after this review. These specs are nothing crazy. You will not be, you know, practically gaming on this system, but for what I use it for, which is a nice thin and light machine that I constantly take to work, that I, you know, view schematics on, view diagrams, manage eBay sales, and just stuff that doesn't necessarily require crazy processing power, it works really well. I carry it around in my normal backpack, not a laptop specific one, which I can really thankfully do thanks to the thin and light form factor. But despite this excellent portability, certainly better portability than my MacBook, it has a nice supply and array of ports. Not something you can say about my MacBook, it's not the M1 version. What we get here is USB-C 65W charging, a Thunderbolt 3 / dock connector if you want to go for that, two USB-A's at 3.0 speeds, one on each side, gigabit Ethernet, HDMI, SD card, and a 3.5mm combo port. This is a stacked set of ports for something this small, and I particularly appreciate having full-size Ethernet with this little connector clip thing that comes out, and Thunderbolt 3. It means that you can connect external GPUs if you really want to, or other PCI devices, and get more out of your laptop. We're also treated to Intel's 2x2 AC Wi-Fi, a 720p webcam found under the built-in privacy cover.
It's not great. Usable. But not great.
Also, a fingerprint scanner, compatible Windows Hello, that's been really nice to have, and power LEDs on both the internal and external logos. You've probably noticed that the general condition of my copy really isn't that good. It's been used an absurd amount by me and the previous owner. This is one that's been, you know, well through the wars and been used well. You can tell by the crazy keypad shine, the crazy trackpad shine, the palm rest shine, the nicks are everywhere. But the thing about this laptop, and the thing that I love about it, is that I could each month spend £20 to £30 on a new part and slowly turn this into a laptop that looks pretty much brand new. The top lid and everything part of the screen assembly looks fairly good in my opinion, as does the bottom casing, or at least good enough in my opinion. The only things that I'd really want to change out are the palm rest, the keyboard, and the trackpad, and I could do those individually 1 month at a time and eventually have something that looks really pristine and clean. This likely isn't something that I'm going to do, purely because this is a work machine and something that is designed to be used and abused in my opinion, but it is nice to have that option. You don't get that on a lot of laptops these days. Speaking of which, this is a little bit upgradable, but not that much. You can put a 2.5-inch drive in here, which will up the storage. You can replace the PCI Express SSD as well. This one is a pretty nice one included, 256GB, 3.5GB read, and I think 1.5GB write, not too bad. 8GB of the RAM is soldered on, and then there's a separate slot so you can up it to a maximum of 24GB with an additional 16GB stick. Whereas with the non-S model, both slots are available to be upgraded, so you could put 32GB in that if you really wanted to. Now, I was quite apprehensive about using the base model CPU in this model, but actually I quite enjoyed my time using it and I will continue to use it. It's more than enough for, say, 10 to 20 browser tabs open at a time, not doing anything crazy, but just sort of going through the motions at work. So a lot of eBay sales, a lot of bringing up documents, editing stuff, emails, just general admin stuff that you'd expect to do on a laptop like this. I'm definitely not running, you know, Blender and 3ds Max and just going nuts with any of that, and I'm certainly not editing any videos on here. But for a general, you know, work laptop, I do a bit of uni work on here, it's more than fast enough. Gaming is a so-so topic for the T480S. Of course, as I said, you know, I have the base model and it performs worse than the higher-end model, obviously. But as long as you're not expecting to play any AAA games, you may be surprised by how well some of the games do load on here. If you're into MOBAs like Dota 2, basic FPS games like CSGO, 2D titles like Stardew Valley and Terraria, or golden oldies like Doom and Quake, the OG ones of course, you can get some gaming done on the T480S, though you will probably have to lower all the settings and maybe the resolution to something more like 720p. I would never play a competitive FPS on this thing, despite the fact it can run CSGO. I just require too high a frame rate and I've got so used to my 240Hz monitor, it feels wrong. But like I said, some games will run, and actually, surprisingly, the fan isn't loud at full whack. Especially compared to my MacBook Pro, which fans you could probably hear upstairs when they're on full whack. I love this keyboard and trackpad. They are amazing to use. They're accurate, they're precise, they're tactile, they're really nice to use. They're maybe not the best I've ever used. I think the trackpad that goes to my MacBook Pro and the keyboard, maybe one of the earlier ThinkPads with the non-chiclet layout, but it does feel really good to type on, and I don't experience the same kind of fatigue typing on this that I do typing on the Apple keyboards. The speakers are pretty awful, actually. I would say that they don't sound particularly full, so you get a very tinny output. This don't sound very good, but you do get the 3.5mm port, and you get Bluetooth as well, which is nice. So if you have wireless cans, you can use those additionally. I am more of an IEM guy, and the fact that I can plug the IEM straight into this, it's nice. And speaking of wireless connectivity, you can actually use a 4G LTE SIM card in here. So there is a slot in the back behind the hinge, and you can actually, you know, connect a SIM card to this and get it on the wireless without needing Wi-Fi, which is nice to have. The 14-inch 1080p IPS screen is great. It's not the most color accurate out of the box, and at 60Hz you won't be using this to competitively game on an FPS, for example, but it is sharp, relatively accurate, bright, and a nice size to balance portability and usability. This is a great laptop display. It gives you loads of screen real estate, obviously being 1080p at 14 inches. It's pretty sharp as well. You know, this isn't gonna compare with any modern MacBook display past 2012, probably, but what it is solid and good enough, in my opinion, for the kind of work that you'll be using this laptop for. You can actually upgrade these with a Quad HD panel, and I'm not sure I would do that, because at 14 inches, I think Quad HD is just not quite, like, needed. And compared to a MacBook, I just feel I wouldn't use this for the same kinds of things that I'd use a MacBook for, so in that regard, maybe not worth it, but entirely possible if you're into that. Let's talk battery life. Lenovo claims this thing will manage 13.5 hours of usage time when it's new, but I got closer to sort of 6 to 7 hours. Now, is that bad for a used laptop of this age? I don't think so. And if I replace the internal cell, I reckon I could get closer to sort of 10 hours on it. But 6 to 7 hours is all that I really require out of a laptop, because I work for about 7 hours a day, and when I'm not using it, I'll power it down and work on whatever I'm doing. So this actually works really nicely. It works out just about right. And charging with the 65 watt charger will get you from 0 to 100 in under 2 hours, which is nice. Though I will say, try and get, if you're going to buy one on the used market, try and get one with an original charger, because they're really hard, or rather really expensive, to buy used, or, you know, third party. and at the same time they struggle to be charged with anything below 45 watts if I remember correctly. So they're a bit picky with which chargers you use over power delivery. However, what I will say is that, you know, if you get one with an original, like I bought mine with an original charger, you shouldn't have any issues, and they're built well enough to where I think you won't need to worry about them breaking. So as long as you get an original one, you should be fine. Now, I know that software is a personal thing when it comes to computers. I know some people prefer Windows, prefer macOS, prefer Linux. I previously used, I think it was Ubuntu on my previous ThinkPad, and I'll likely be switching over to Manjaro on this. I think it's just a bit nicer than Ubuntu, and I think that it works for my applications a little bit better. But currently I have Windows 11 Pro on here, which is just a buggier version of Windows 10 Pro, which is already not great. Some people will swear by Windows, and for you, you know, power to you, you're very lucky people to have never run into issues with it. I personally am more of a macOS person. However, as you can tell by my screens behind me, you know, I do have a gaming computer, always pretty much have done since I could afford to buy one, and that runs Windows. So, you know, it's not like I'm completely against using Windows, but I'd rather not. This thing came with a Windows 10 Pro license, so I thought, screw it, I'll upgrade it to 11 Pro. And it's ran okay. It's not the best. There are some issues that I've had with it just shutting down randomly that I didn't have on Windows 10, and I don't have with other Linux. You know, I've tried Linux on here a couple of times. We may be going back to Manjaro to completely eliminate those problems. And overall, this is a really nice laptop. For those enthusiasts, you might want to go with the non-S model purely for its the more upgradability, essentially. But the S model does have its benefits. Of course, it is thinner and lighter by a fairly significant amount, and it's able to actually be it's built a little bit better, so I think you can sort of throw it around a little bit more. That isn't to say that the non-S is built particularly poorly, but this is just built a bit nicer. And with that, I'm going to leave today's video, guys. Do check out ThinkPads. They're great. You know, I love them. And buy them on the used market. Don't buy a brand new one. Like, yeah, I mean, sure, but like, I don't know. I feel like their best value is on the used market. I still stand by my comment. The best cheap laptop is a used ThinkPad for sure. I'll leave links to the one I have in the video description. And also, I will leave links to everything else, including my podcast, which I've enjoyed creating content for recently. We have a couple of legends coming on, so stay tuned for that. I want to give a massive shout out to my patrons for being continually supportive, and also check out all the links in the video description. Like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. I've been Ryan Thomas, and I'll catch you later. Peace.